have not yet been able to dig ourselves out of it. It is time that we dig ourselves out of that hole. According to the article, U.S. falls to average in education ranking by against France Press. We are currently in 17th place for science and a below average 25th for mathematics in a 3-yearly OECD program for International Student Assessment Report, which compares the knowledge and skills of 15-year-olds in 70 countries around the world. The U.S. is currently ranked 14 out of 34 OECD countries for reading skills. And I believe the reason for that is that we are not targeting the root of the problem. That root of the problem is our early young students, ranging from elementary, first grade, all the way to sixth grade. I myself have worked with young students ranging from first all the way to sixth grade through the Boys and Girls Club of America. I've clearly seen that they are not receiving the right amount of homework in order to learn a certain topic or a subject, and therefore enabling them to risk flunking in other in their educational futures. I've also seen and acknowledged that the elementary years of students are really important years that shape the future of every student. I've seen that through working with the Boys and Girls Club of America. According to the an article on the Ranking America website, last updated on January 6, 2015, the U.S. is ranked a staggering 14th place in education. And we need to change that. Today, we need to change that because the U.S. Is ranked 14th place in education because of its because we are not actually focusing on the root of the problem. That root being educating our young students, by giving them and assigning them 2 hours of homework each day, and enforcing that teachers will encourage and motivate students throughout their education. So if we by the end of the speech, you guys will hopefully understand that education is a true vital factor, and that if we do not make this change to our contemporary education, we might suffer in the future. So today I would like to first identify the problem, second explain what is causing the problem, and third introduce the best possible solutions. So first, the problem. Let's first see what the problem is. According to the website article on the Ranking of America website, here are the top 10 countries in education at this time. I remind you that this is updated as of January 6, 2015. So these are the top 10 countries rated, ranked amongst the Kinetic Skills and Educational Attainment Rates. So take a moment and look at this. The U.S. is in, you guys might be wondering, where the heck is the U.S. at? Well, aren't we like a country with like the most, aren't we the most powerful country? Aren't we ranked among one of the top most economies? Believe it or not, the U.S. ranks 14 in education. The cognitive skills and education attainment score of 0.39. So, but don't worry, it's not the, not all ranks. The U.S. doesn't rank low in all rankings. It actually is pretty high in some rankings. For example, this one. According to the article in the Ranking of America website, last updated on October 30, 2014, the United States is ranked second out of 14 in ignorance. So that's what brings us to problem number two. According to another article, the United States is ranked second out of the 14 countries in general ignorance about social statistics such as teen pregnancy, unemployment rates, and voting patterns. Italy, being the most ignorant of 14 countries, is ranked first. So what is causing this horrible statistics, and why are we ranked so low? So that's what brings us to the causes. Cause number one, the main cause is that students are not mentally prepared to move on to the next grade. According to the article, the education process on the realtruth.org website, about 13% of all 17-year-olds and perhaps 40% of minority youth were functionally illiterate. Cause number two is, according to the same article, the education process on the realtruth.org website, only 33% of 8th graders were at a proficient in reading performance, with 26% scoring below basic. This shows that because of the bad test scores, we are considered to be ranked low on the educational scale. And at this point, which is 8th graders, we should already be well developed in our education. So the problem should be before the 8th grade, which is elementary. So that's why I think targeting our early young students is the targeting the root. So targeting our early compulsory education, so elementary students. So the solutions would be, teachers must give out at least 2 hours of homework each day and motivate students to learn instead of making them feel incapable of learning even though they are struggling. And then provide free tutoring with taxpayers' money to all students who are having trouble learning a subject. So throughout the through my experience in the Boys and Girls Club of America, I've noticed and I've seen that if that students aren't receiving as much homework as they have to receive. And that is something that we need to fix by giving at least 2 hours of homework every day for each student. And provide free tutoring. I've seen that if every student receives a little bit of help with their homework, they actually learn faster. And I've seen also that that if you don't motivate them, they don't feel pressured to learn and they just like give up and they don't care about their studies anymore. So this will solve the issue. So in essence, we have to understand the problems of our nation and analyze its causes. Now it's time for us to either implement these solutions or just simply cross our hands and start saying goodbye to our powerful economy, technology, reputation, and science reputation of the future. So let's make a better future for our future generations to come. Let's make sure that our kids will be able to grow up in a well-educated nation for the possibilities. If you want your future kids to have a successful life, then we need to start making this small change in our educational system. Let's ignite the small spark that will fire up a whole new nation full of well-educated people. Yeah, it's time to climb out of the educational crisis.